Scoreless for the final three games. Will be Loyola ball right to left here in the second half. RJ Williams gets the start in the second half with Cormier, Olson, Atherly, and Brooks for the Greyhounds. Wimbush started, will not start the second half. There's a more traditional lineup with Williams at the point to start here for Jimmy Patsos. Left side, Cormier, top of the key, Williams. Feeds the post inside. Driving lane is no good by Atherly, and the rebound taken away by Anisicki, his fifth.
Block shot, I believe, by O.D. Anisicki. Good defense from behind. Looked like the Saints had given up another easy shot in the middle of their zone defense.
If so, it'll be the Saints' fourth of the game. He does get a rebound there, his fifth to go along with the team-high 8 points. Inside, muscles it up with the right hand, no good. Rebound taken away by Atherly.
Just a little bit short on that right-handed jump.
Quickly ahead, inside Brooks, turns around, no good, but he got fouled. Saints a little slow to get back, and Julius Brooks will shoot a pair.
Wow, phantom foul right there.
Well, led by Dylan Cormier in the first half, 10 points, 3 steals. Atherly, Brooks, and Olson all had 6 and 5 for Anthony Wimbush. Brooks 3 of 5 shooting in the first half. Had that big shot to win the game at Niagara as he misses the first shot. Loyola just 5 of 10 from the line in this game. Much to the dismay of Jimmy Patsos. Got to make these free throws, especially with March coming up. And he missed them both. Verdeen the rebound. Not great foul shooting by either team tonight. Both have had their chances. Siena 9 of 16. Loyola just 5 of 11.
Small victory for the Saints. Loyola continues their man-to-man defense.
Anisicki inside, spins right hand off the window, too strong. Silas couldn't handle the putback, and then he ran into Brooks and gets called for a touch foul, the third on Emo.
Well, that time OD turned off the left shoulder to the right-handed jump hook. Emo Silas's man, which was Eric Heffley, came over for the block shot. That could have been a nice little dump off for a wide open dunk. Instead, Emo tried to attack the rim, but the ball came off the other side. He fouled. Brooks on the rebound.
Atherly inside, muscles it up, no good. Olson offensive rebound, reverse lane, won't go. Pull the rebound for the Saints, and Loyola going on 5 minutes without a point here. Verdeen inside, muscles it up, too strong. Anisicki right there.
OD Anisicki!
Attacking the rim was Trinity Verdeen, making things happen.
And a timeout by Jimmy Patsos. The clock was having an issue first. The shot clock never started either. It says 35. Jimmy was about to call a timeout anyways. And dating back to the first half, a 10-0 run for the Saints. Scoreboard says 37-29, but it's 37-31 Loyola. Company is a proud partner of Siena Athletics. Also a special thanks to Dr. Amish Kerr of Albany Medical Center, the official sports medicine provider. Athletics, 37-39, and a 10-0 run for the Saints.
20 seconds to go. $40 in the pocket.
Loyola hasn't scored
$50
in the last 5 minutes here.
$60.
Field goal of the first half.
He's got 10.
Jimmy Patsos called the timeout,
got
out until the ball
bucks.
Got up to half court. It says 35, but it's 30 up there for the
Coach
Greyhounds.
Coach Jackson is making note of the $90 Erica just won.
And now they're inbounding from under their own roof, so maybe they're saying the timeout came.
I'm not sure.
He took about 4 or 5 dribbles up the court before the timeout.
I think it was the bucket scored, and I think they called the timeout then.
So we started up here with RJ Williams across the midcourt stripe. Loyola's gone cold after they were so hot so early, shooting well over 50% for most of the first half, 52% at the break as Williams misses again. And is Siki another rebound, and the drought continues for Loyola.
I know D does a good job of slowing down the Siena offense, even when one of the Loyola players had fallen out of bounds.
Well, Siena went 6 minutes without scoring in the first half. Loyola coming up on 6 minutes without a point here, spanning two halves. Poole inside almost walked, and now they will call steps. Late call from John Corso, and struggles continue for up. They didn't have a field goal until late on Thursday night against Fairfield, and we talked about it earlier, Tom. Hasn't been the same since coming back after missing all that time with the flu.
No, and even though that call was late, it was the right call. But another turnover for the Saints.
Bulls only taking a couple three-point attempts tonight, missed them both. Scoreless in the game. Wimbush down low and Siki trying to spin, lost the handle, gets it back, kicks it left side. Olson up fake, now pull up from 14 is good. And the first points in 6 minutes for Loyola. From Robert Olson, it ends at 10-0. Siena run 39-31. Loyola with 17:15 to play.
Good play right there by Olson. One dribble to his right for the pull-up.
Ball's loose on the ground, and coming away with it is Wimbush for the Greyhounds. Williams, left corner, Olson baseline three is good. Big back-to-back baskets by Robert Olson, who has a couple words for the fans in the front row as he puts Loyola back up double figures.
Big bucket after another Siena turnover. Back-to-back turnovers for the Saints, five straight points for the Greyhounds.
42-31, Loyola the lead now with 16:40 to play. Left to right, Rob Poole for Siena. Poole trying to get inside, tied up, back out to Anisicki now. Anisicki 20 feet away from the hoop, now trying to spin inside, out to Burdine. Burdine drives lane, free throw line, floaters an air ball. And Williams comes out of the pack, leading Olson ahead, one-on-one with Poole, lays it up, no, but Robbie commits the foul. Poole, that is, on the foul. Olson to the line for two. One Rob fouls the other.
That's his first personal.
And Olson able to end the drought for Loyola and a chance to add their sixth and seventh points in a row here after they had gone scoreless for so long, and now to put them back in control.
Well, this is where Siena can ill afford to allow Loyola to go on any type of lengthy run, because when you're already down by six, trying to continue to get back into the game, what happens is currently this 6-0 run by Loyola puts them back up by 12. Now 13.
And just like that, a 7-0 run, all from Robert Olson for the Greyhounds. 44-31 Loyola with 16:20 to play. Greyhounds have led by as many as 19 and now back up by Baker's dozen. Pull between the circles left to right. Feeds the post to Anisicki on the low block, trying to spin inside, puts it up, no good. Might have got a piece of that. Did Brooks, blocked up by the official there, and now a foul is called on the Saints. And oh, another late foul. They're going to count the basket. Gary Tracy says count the basket. And now a pushing and shoving on the court. Pull in the middle of it again with Brooks. And here come the players, the officials, to try and break it up. And these two teams exchanged pleasantries 8 days ago in Baltimore, mostly Poole and Olson. And Rob Poole was in the middle of it again that time, pushing and shoving with Julius Brooks.
Well, we might as well go to a commercial break, because now the referees are going to go to the monitor to see if anything happened. But really, it was just Emo Silas got his feet caught up with Dylan Cormier. And as his feet were on top of him, Cormier took offense and kind of started pushing and shoving. And then the players, of course, were just reacting to that.
Well, we're not under 16, so no media timeout yet, but they will talk things over. And you're absolutely right, the shot was partially blocked in transition, the foul been called, Silas coming late, deflected, and a tough break for Siena's. I believe they counted the basket, they haven't put it on the scoreboard yet. And then, as you said, feet got tied up, Silas and Cormier going down to the court, and that ended with a bit of a fracas going on. So the officials settling it out as Will Bush at the scorer's table right now. And I saw Will Bush saying to assistant coach Craig Carter, making the sign like a technical against one of the Siena players. And I'd be surprised if we don't have matching technicals here, but we'll have to see how they rule it. And Poole was in the middle of it. Players went down. I believe Heim started a little bit of the pushing down low, and then Poole came in from behind. Don't think he really did much, just someone the Greyhounds have targeted, it seems, the last week or so, and Brooks gave him a big push. Jimmy Patsos running into the scrum and just bear hogged Brooks and got him right out of the way.
Technical charge to Evan Hines. That'll go as his second personal.
Well, they're going to give a technical to Evan Hines and one to Julius Brooks. Count the basket for Cormier on the goaltend to put Loyola up by 15. And hell of a chance of a three-point play once things get settled out.
The classic offsetting technical fouls.
So Cormier with the dozen, and just what Siena made it a two-possession game on a 10-0 run spanning both halves. The Greyhounds, a 9-0 run, and a chance to answer Siena's 10-0 run with a 10-0 run of their own here. Tough breaks for the Saints. As Cormier's foul shot is up and good. 13 for Cormier to lead all scorers, along with Robert Olson, who also has 13, and Loyola answers Siena's 10-0 run with one of their own. 47-31 Greyhounds, 15:50 to play. Pull between the circles, left to right, hands it off now to Hines. Having a couple threes in the game. Dribbles on the right side, trapped again, trying to get inside. Now it's to Burdeen, 12 to shoot. Hands it off to Poole, picked up there by Olson. Poole with 8 to shoot, dribbles around left side in traffic, drives the lane, cut off. Out to Himes, long three before the horn is no good. Rebound Anasicki, can't keep it alive as Williams got it. Was tied up and fouled by Williams, and we've got a timeout on the court. 15:23 to go.
It's a foul on Anasicki.
Colin Anasicki, excuse me, 15:23 to go here in Albany. A 10-0 run for the Greyhounds. They lead Siena 47-31 on the Talk 1300 Siena Basketball Radio Network.
Talk 1300 Sports. The team's getting along so well. It's your turn. If you're up on the board, you got to kiss the one next to you. Even if they're a Yankee fan. That's the way it works. That's the Kiss Cam.
To learn more or to discover how you or your company can get involved,
and they're going
to
kiss.
JChuckFromHeaven.com.
Oh!
That's JChuckFromHeaven.com.
Making the most of his time. It's more than a Kiss Cam. It's an engagement cam.
Choose an exterior full color that transforms your home.
That would be Siena Class of 2007, Lisa Perrone and Ryan Woods. Ryan said, will you? Lisa said yes. So cheer for Lisa Woods. The future Mr. and Mrs. Woods. Class of 2007. Congratulations.
The Saints are home tonight.
From one terrible alumni getting engaged to another getting married.
15:23 to go, second half in Albany. Saints have made a big run, 10-0 to cut the lead. That was the six, but the Greyhounds have answered back with a 10-0 run of their own to go back on top by 16.
One game, about 30 seconds now.
47-31 the lead here for Loyola. Greyhounds shooting 50% in the game and starting to pull away once again.
Yeah, the Saints did such a great job in the last 4 minutes, getting the momentum swung in their favor, getting the deficit at the half down to manageable numbers to just 8. They get the nice basket to start the second half, and then everything is kind of unraveled. Another missed shot, another missed opportunity at the offensive end, a couple turnovers, and after just 4.5 minutes, the Saints are down by 16 again. And they're just digging themselves another hole that they may not be able to climb out of.
Siena shot 50% in the first half, have missed 6 of 7 here in the second half. And again, Loyola taking advantage of Siena's miscues. They've only turned it over twice in the second half, but Loyola scored 5 points off them. Greyhounds with 19 points off 12 Siena turnovers tonight as Olson hits another jumper along to 15 for Robert Olson, including 9 already in the first 5 minutes of the second half.
Nice set play against the zone defense, getting Olson a screen on the perimeter. The Saints really had no answer for that. Olson gets another 17-foot jump shot.
Himes blocked from behind by Olson, out of bounds. Will stay with the Saints, but a big first half for the senior out of Silver Spring, Maryland, a 12-0 run for Loyola, and Robert Olson has 9 of them, a game-high 15 for him. Saints trying to answer back now. Himes in traffic, has his pocket picked by Williams. Shoulder right into Williams, who is waiting to take the ball away from him. Turnover number 13. And again, the Times Union Center has grown silent. Could hear a pin drop in here right now. Olson trying to get around pull, back outside Williams, top of the key, Cormier, 13 to shoot, and they'll reset out now by midcourt. Cormier out by the Mac logo, looking for the screen right, trying to take Himes inside, lays it off the window, count it, and the foul for Dylan Cormier, and make it a 20-point Loyola lead, their biggest of the night. Third foul on Himes, who got his second on the team moments ago. And Dylan Cormier and the Greyhounds starting to pull away. 15 now for Cormier. And he hits the foul shot, and it's a 15-0 run for Loyola. They lead it 52-31 with 14:10 to go. Saints scored the first basket of the second half. 15 unanswered points for Loyola Saints. And this one is getting away here from the Saints. Played Loyola so well for about 35 minutes 8 days ago. Martins inside got fouled, and Davis Martins, who had 6 points in 6 minutes on 3 of 3 shooting in the first half, giving Siena a bit of a spark off the bench. And we'll get 2 free throws.
Nice aggressive play right there by Davis Martins. But I gotta be honest with you, I've never seen so many calls made in the game where the players literally look at the officials like, what are you calling? And that one for Loyola was just that, as Davis Martins took one dribble from the foul line, attempted the shot.
Richard
Bisping coming in, and a rare substitution in the second half for the senior.
Martins already with a season high, 6 career highs, 8 for Davis, who makes 1 of 2. And that ends the 15-0 run for Loyola. 52-32 Greyhounds with 13:48 to play. Saints is 6-20 on the year, 4-11 in the MAC, and in danger of losing a 12th conference game. Pass is turned over. Here comes Himes, 3-on-1. Evan keeps it himself, lays it up, got fouled by Williams, and he'll get a couple of free throws.
Well, another 3-on-1 break for the Saints, and luckily they got a foul call, but they're not getting an easy layup. That, to me, could have been a possible pass to Rich Adu for an alley-oop, but Evan instead chose to take the ball right at R.J. Williams.
Well, definitely some growing pains for this young Siena team this year, losing 20 games this season as Himes hit the first, just the third time in program history, and in danger of the all-time record of 24 back in 04-05. Siena 20 already, and barring a major comeback tonight, would make it 21 on the season. As Himes misses the second, rebound to Cormier and Loyola. 52-33, Loyola in control with 13:20 to play. Cormier in traffic, as the ball knocked away. Here's Bisping, 4-on-2 again for the Saints, finding a do. Almost went out of bounds. Green, count it, and the basket, a broken play, but a good job, A, by Adu to save it, and then find Burdine for the basket and one.
Tremendous play by Richard Dews. The Saints once again had numbers. They had the advantage, 3-on-2, and just a terrible pass by Evan Hines. Barely saved by Richard Dews as he's literally flying out of bounds, knocked a carry basket over, and throws it to Trinity Burdine, who finishes for a layup. Not a typical 3-on-2 layup that you would like to get, but it worked, and the Saints will continue to cut into this deficit.
Burdine in double figures for the 7th time this year as he hits the free throw. He and Anasicki 10 apiece to lead the Saints. As Siena completes the 3-point play, quickly ahead inside the other way, and an easy lane for Latham. As Loyola answers right back, 54-36 Loyola, 7 minutes into the second half. Now the Saints complete the 3-point play, but they couldn't get back as a pick ball on Wimbush here. And Brooks will come back in for Latham. Had a 2-on-1, and
Loyola switches to a 1-3-1 defense where they have Olson and Williams playing the wings. Where you have the advantage here is when you reverse it, look for the skip pass over the top with Williams at the low post.
And Martins is blocked from behind by Wimbush. Too slow developing. He was open in the zone at the foul line, turned around, but took too much time. An easy block from behind. Now Loyola back across the midcourt stripe, leading by 18 here over the Saints. Wimbush drives in from the right side, out to Olson. He'll drive the lane in traffic, and a blocking foul's called on Martins as Olson ran over Davis, who apparently didn't have his feet set. He anticipated it, but apparently not quite set down there.
His first teammate, Robert Olson, to the line.
First foul on Davis, that's already 8 team fouls here on the Saints, 7.5 minutes into the second half. Loyola with the foul trouble in the first half. It's been Siena's Achilles heel here in the second. As Olson hits the first, and Silas will replace Martins. One more here for Olson. And he gets them both. 17 for Olson. We'll check out Cormier, who has 50 in the Greyhounds, two leading scorers who have led them to a 20-point lead, 56-36, with 12:27 to play. Himes, Adu, Berdine, Silas, and Bisping, the five on the floor for the Saints as they go left to right. Himes, 30 feet away, now gets a bit of a trap out on him in midcourt. Again, the 1-3-1 Tom alluded to moments ago. Himes, nice dump down to Berdine for the right lane. Here's a nice pass from Evan. Up in midair, thought he might pass it, but a bullet pass down low to Berdine in motion for the lay-in.
There's that skip pass opposite against that 1-3-1 zone, making the wing drop. Himes went up for the jump shot, had the drop-off pass for an easy lay-in, like you mentioned. Very good pass by Evan Himes.
Dozen points now for Trinity. 56-38. Loyola Saints can ill afford to continue to trade baskets here. Cormier steps into a three, no good. Himes the rebound, has Adu out front. Finds him, Adu in the open court, lays it up and in. Timeout by Mitch Bonaguero. The Saints pull within 16 with 11:26 to play.
Another assist by Evan Himes. Good hands defensively for the Saints. Forced a turnover, and instead of trying to dribble it in traffic, Himes throws it up ahead.
Siena making a little bit of a run here. 56 to 40 with 11:26 to go. They've made a couple of runs in this game, and if they're going to make one in this game, they better do it now. You're down 16 with 11:26 to go.
Well, Saints had the momentum there after the bucket and the turnover. Look at the timeout. Thank you. Media timeout was coming up. Saints are down 16, though. See if they three-quarters court press. I will say O.D. Anasicki on the bench in the second half. He hasn't been on the bench this long in the second half of any game this season, so Mitch Bonaguero going with Berdine, Himes, Adu, Bisping, and Silas.
That's a great point, Tom. He's been over there for a while. He's played reasonably well tonight. 10 points, 7 rebounds. Haven't seen anything that would make you think he's injured at all. As Bisping knocks away the ball, here's another 4-on-2, but the pass is missed. As getting back defensively was Cormier to pick it away from Berdine.
Nice steal by Bisping, anticipating that long cross-court pass. That's exactly what you want your big guys to do. Come up on those long passes, pick them off when they're in the air that long.
So it'll be Adu, Himes, Berdine, Silas, and Bisping for the Saints. Again, Anasicki on the bench. Inside shot is up and in. And a chance at a three-point play for Atherly after a timeout on the court. Brought to you by All-Star Wine and Spirits. 10:56 to go, second half at Albany. It's Loyola 58, Siena 40. On Talk 1300, Siena Basketball Radio Network.
All right, folks, it's time for tonight's endless 6, 7, 7, 9 minutes. Tonight's contestant is from Johnny Applestack. We got Paul with us, Paul Henry. He's got a stack, 4 apples on top of each other, forming a freestanding apple tower. If the tower falls over, it can be restacked. He's got to do them all right here. 4 apples, Pete. They have four the best selection of pies I have ever seen.
They have a fair on site,
tailor shop, and quality service that Mark Thomas and experience can never forget. And they have gift certificates of value, too.
What type of apple is it?
All season, Mark Thomas back.
Delicious, you're a very typical goal with a point bottom.
Mark Thomas, Kansas Power, located off Wolf
Creek. There we go, Pat Cross. We got two. That's it.
Military, it's a rally.
All
This one was an apple stacking contest. Interesting.
Give credit to corporate sales manager Tim Farrell, who spends countless hours looking for the next idea for a
pouring over the internet, yeah, and whatever TV shows he can come up with to come up with the next big promotion.
And after he completes a three-point play, I especially like the one where they had the ding-dong on the forehead. And you had to try and get it in your mouth without using your hands a few games ago. Greyhounds back up 19. Himes NBA 3 is long, which creates a long rebound out to Rich Adu and a reset for the Saints. Long 3, long rebound. Berdine. Martins on the right block. Davis had some room, now pulls it back out to Himes. Himes dribbles inside in traffic, kicks it out left side. Dribbling in is Bisping up at the right hand, no good. A rebound to Martins, who lays
there. Davis Martins!
And Davis Martins with the new career high 9 points and another timeout by Siena, Tom.
Saints use another timeout after a nice offensive rebound by Davis Martins. Saints have 2 left.
Career high 9 for Davis on 4 or 5 shooting, and mystified a little bit. There was the one right before the media timeout. They got the fast break lay in, and then the very next time they scored down the court, another timeout. 17-point game with 10:24 to go. Thoughts on the rationale behind that?
Give yourself the chance to set up a one more press. I don't know. That's what they're coming out in.
See if it pays off with the Saints. Over 10 times tonight. Be Berdine, Himes, Adu, Martins, and Bisping out there. Loyola breaks it with ease. Now a youth down low, and it's flushed home by Julius Brooks. Nice feed from Wimbush. So whatever was drawn up there wasn't the right play for the Saints.
Well, that's how you attack a press. You don't just accept the fact that you got the ball over half court. You look where there's opportunities, and that pass over the top to an athletic Brooks was a great opportunity and exciting play, gets your team going.
Loyola now shooting 54% in the game as Adu turns it over. Back up Loyola again the other way. Etherly inside spins out to Wimbush and a reset with 9:40 to go, and Loyola up by 19. Greyhounds shooting 22 of 40 for the game. Siena meanwhile has cooled off in the second half, just 33% in the stanza. Down at 10 to shoot now. They'll reset with Wimbush. Versatile player. Out on the perimeter now for Loyola. Down to 5. Right side, Olson. Calls for the screen. Steps into a 3. Got it. With the shot clock about to expire. And Robert Olson gives Loyola its biggest lead of the game. They're up by 22 points.
Shot right over Evan Himes.
20 for Olson. 64-42 Loyola with 9 minutes to play. Himes, screen right, gets it left side to Martins. Martins, cut off, looking for some help. Back outside now to Adu, 10 to shoot for the Saints. And not a lot of open looks right now. Himes gets a screen, dumps it inside to Bisping, muscles it up in traffic. No, but he got hacked, and he'll go to the line for a pair.
We've shown Bisping put the ball to the floor. We've shown him attempt shots off the move in this game. That was another nice move by Bisping. Baseline pass and first cutting. Had to put the ball to the deck one time. Slice it between defenders. Attempts the left-handed lane. Like the versatility of a 6'8" freshman right there.
And he's able to hit the first free throw for Bisping, who came back on Thursday against the Stags. Makes them both, 64-44, the deficit, 20 for the Saints with 8:39 to play. First points of the game for Brett Bisping. Siena, 13 points off the bench tonight. Inside Ethelie, another easy two over Bisping. And Ethelie now into double figures for the Greyhounds. Third Loyola player there, 66-46 Loyola lead. Himes, another long three. Off again, a rebound to Brooks. Bombs away against the 1-3-1 here for the Saints, but they haven't been able to hit a three, just 2 of 9 in the game.
That was a deep three right there by Himes. He's capable of making that, but it's just a lower percentage shot.
Right to left, Olson back outside now to Wimbush. And they'll reset with Cormier with 15 to shoot. Loyola in no hurry here, up by 22, under 8 to go. Olson kicks in the left corner. Gets it back now with 6, trying to drive on Adu, cut off there. Out to Ethelie, now a 3 from Cormier is good. Once again with 1 second on the shot clock, another dagger from the Greyhounds to go up 25.
Well, every offense looks good when you're making shots, and right now, Loyola just hanging on to the ball long enough, and then they're making shots late in the shot clock, which is tough for the Saints when you're trying to come back.
And those ones are the ones that hurt the most. You know, they're going to take time off the clock and then adding insult to injury, scoring a couple times there before the shot clock was going to expire. Himes in a lot of traffic up and under, lays it up, no good. Nice. And cleared up by Wimbush.
Nice move, athletic play by Himes, but just couldn't convert the lay-in in traffic.
So Loyola with its biggest lead of the game, up 25. As we go under 7 minutes to play, all Greyhounds tonight coming in a game back of Niagara for first in the MAC, and the defending MAC champions well on their way to staying in second place after the night. Nice spin move inside, Ethelie with the left hand, no good. Rebound comes down to Cormier, and traffic got fouled, and he'll shoot free throws after a timeout on the court. All Loyola here tonight. They lead Siena by 25, 69-44 Greyhounds, 6:39 to play on the Talk 1300 Siena Basketball Radio Network.
6:39 to go in the second half.
Is changing the way you travel throughout the capital region with new
and now please welcome back to Siena's Cheer Team.
Bus routes will run more often later at night and feature added Sunday service. So whether you need to get to work, to school, or enjoy a safe night out, let CDTA take you there. All at a great price. CDTA asks, what's your number? To stay connected and keep up with all that CDTA is including, call me at
second half in Albany. Mike Emo's Tom Herter joining you courtside where the Greyhounds are racing past the Saints, leading by 25, 69 to 44.
Second half has not been kind to the Saints. Yes, of late. They had an 8-game stretch where they're getting outscored basically 38 to 29. This game is down 37-29 at the half. Loyola has just been on fire.
32-15 in the second half as Cormier shoots a pair and makes the first. How about this second half for you, Tom? Loyola shooting 65% in the second half. Siena 29.
Villanova-like.
Greyhounds at 57% for the game. As Cormier hits them both. And the points just keep on coming for the Greyhounds. 71-44, the lead up to 27 with 6:35 to play. The Saints are going to have a long time off after this one. Bracket Buster game next Sunday against Radford. A noon tip-off here at the Times Union Center. Himes straight away three, and it's no good. Yet again, Olson the rebound. And again, I know the bracket buster game doesn't carry much weight for Siena, especially this year, but a long time before that game and a lot of things to work on for the Saints.
There definitely are, and it gives them a chance to play against a team that, you know, doesn't necessarily know them that well. They'll be scouted, of course, but.
Inside shot, no good. Tip back up and in. How do you like that for Julius Brooks?
Everything going the Greyhounds way.
And a 29-point lead and a 9-0 run for the Greyhounds. How many of those have they had tonight?
More than enough.
15-2 in the first half at one point. 15-0 in the second half earlier. So they've had a 15-2, a 15-0, and a 9-0 run in this game now. A new left wing open three is good. By Evan Himes, his fourth assist, finding a new for three. And Mitch Bonaguirre calls another timeout. Going out of style tonight.
Well, there is a limit to how many timeouts we can
They have one left down 26 with 5:24 to go. I'm going to get Marcus Hopper into the game. And once again, I know the game has gotten away now from the Saints at this point, Tom, but Odie Anisicki, we didn't really see too much of him in the second half, but it was still a game early on, and now especially since Loyola was pulled away, and no signs of him coming back in. 25 minutes tonight for OD.
Yeah, I mean,
make some noise if you want the last t-shirt of the night.
It's gotten up to 26, so I think we haven't seen him go to the bench very often in the second half of any game, so hard to read into something, but you know, this has just not been a good second half for the Saints. Can't say enough. They're down 8 at the half. Now they're down by 26 after making the field goal.
And again, I know 8 days until Radford, and really over 2 weeks, or 2 weeks rather, to the next MAC game down the stretch. You want your team to be healthy and well rested, and no excuse, your OD is going to get a very good rest, and you hope that your best player is going to be more than well rested for the last few games of the regular season to the tournament as a result. You'll have plenty of rest, that's for sure. 73-47 Loyola. Cormier catch and shoot, spins out. Rebound Silas, as you mentioned before, Marcus Hopper coming off his first points of the season into the game for the first time. Has played a grand total of 7 minutes this season.
Loyola still has 4 of their 5 starters in the game.
One more minute than Steven Cruz we might see soon. Himes inside, high off the window, no good. And it goes out of bounds. It'll stay with the Saints. Cruz, who has a knack for hitting the shots at the end of games lately.
Big shots.
Might see him in soon. Did it against Loyola. Of course, you remember I owned in the MAC tournament a couple of years ago. And pretty much it, but still some shots at the end for Steven. Hopper inside, posting up, tries to muscle up, wild shot, missed everything. Trying to draw a foul perhaps, and Latham completely shuts him down and gets the rebound.
Latham's a tough player to go through, big physical.
Coming up on 4.5 to play in the Greyhounds, leading by 26. They've led by as many as 29 until the Adu 3 moments ago. Williams inside, left side, Cormier open 3. Nope. Battle for the rebound, Berdine has it. Himes looks to run the other way, left to right. Evan hands it off to Hopper, up take off the window, rejected by Jordan Latham again. Now a 2-on-1, Cormier, alley-oop. Can't find that, fully comes down with it, back up with the left hand, no good. And the rebound to Hopper. Marcus Hopper might want to take a long, hard thought before attempting a third shot here again against Jordan Latham. To say it's a mismatch between the two number 15s on the court would be an understatement. 3:38 to go, mercifully, in this one. Himes inside again, up and under, blocked by Cormier. That's 3 blocks in a row by the Greyhounds on the Saints. 73-47 Loyola with 3:20 to play. Williams gets around Berdine, dumps down Cormier, up and under, no, but he got fouled and will shoot more free throws after a timeout on the court. 3:14 to go in Albany. All Loyola, they lead the Saints 73-47. Timeout on the court. Brought to you by All-Star Wine and Spirits on the Talk 1300 Siena Basketball Radio Network.
Fans, bring your team inside for free appetizers and hamburgers from any Recovery Sports Bill Limited. Recovery Sports Bill, official sports card will for the athletics.
Siena, first team to do that since Marist beat the Saints six in a row from 2004 to 2007. We talked about a number of key Saints not playing much in the second half. Meanwhile, Jimmy Patsos has got three of five starters, plus R.J. Williams, who plays a lot of minutes still in the game right now. An interesting move on his side.
Yeah.
Well, Jimmy loves coming to Albany, and he's going to savor every moment of this one, his last game coaching here as a MAC coach.
He has in recent years, at least. He might love the restaurants, but he still wants to come up here and get a victory.
Cormier hits the front end of a 1-1. Balanced attack for Loyola tonight. Cormier with 20, 20 for Olson, 11 for Ethley, and 10 for Julius Brooks. Verdeen leads the Saints with a dozen, 10 for Anisicki, who hasn't played in about the last 10 minutes for the Saints. No known injury or other reasons for OD, foul trouble or alike, just hasn't played out there. Himes inside, Silas up fake with the right hand off the window and got the roll.
Emo Silas.
As he's got 4 points, four boards, a couple blocks, coming off that nice game on Thursday against Fairfield, and something to look forward to. Tom, an athletic player who's shown some glimpses here of the future.
Strong, athletic player. He's got a lot of upside.
Cormier, three. Good. Dylan Cormier with 23. And Jimmy Patsos will call the quick timeout to get wholesale substitutions in the old hockey line change into the game. Luke Wandrich, Shido on a UK. Tyler Hubbard, Eric Laster. And who are we missing out there? Missing one player, and that is
Chris Levin in the lineup for the Saints.
Franz. How can we forget Franz? Franz Rossman, the 6'8 freshman from Tacoma Park, Maryland. With Loyola up 29, I'll do a three is good.
3 points.
8 points off the bench. Tonight we talk about Silas and also Adu, who's got extended minutes with Brookins and Oliver out. And he forces the turnover here. Chris Lepinen into the game. Gets it ahead to Adu. And good to see Rich playing well here down the stretch. Silas posting up. Spinning on Rossman with the left hand. Losses the
Emo
set. Nice set again by Emo.
Strong player, very crafty in the low post, very.
That's a little
fake moves, goes one way, turns off the other shoulder. And Patsos wants to tell everyone he's still coaching, even though his team is up by 24 points.
There are a lot of times I'd like to be a fly on the wall in a Jimmy Patsos huddle, but he's got five players who combined probably average about 15 minutes a game this year on the court right now. They've given up five quick points to the Saints. What are you saying to this group out here, which really doesn't play that much?
If you guys give up a 24-0 run, I'm going to take you out. Maybe that's what he said.
And for those players who do have a scholarship, they probably won't have one anymore. We'll get Jared Jones back into the game here. 1:54 to go. Loyola up by 24 as Wandrish leads Loyola to the front court. Kind of a who's who of Greyhounds on the court right now. I think Tom Herter Jr. might be next to the game.
I think I'll let him continue his high school career.
Prior to the post-game call and show, SienaSaints.com post-game report, taking your calls. Leppinen the block on Wandrish. Poole the rebound. It's Leppinen, Hopper, Adu, Silas, and Poole. And I think that might be the first time these five have played together this year. Silas inside, muscles Leppinen in the foul for Emo. Silas doing good work here late as Silas.
Another strong move.
Again, we know who he's playing against. The second unit here, and third unit even, if you want to go that far, but good to get some confidence going, playing well down the stretch, good minutes for Emo, and for Rich Adu as well here at garbage time. And Emo completes a three-point play. Nice lead on for Silas.
8-0 run for the Saints.
78-57, break up the Saints with 70 seconds to go. It's going to kill the plus minus of this third grouping out here for Loyola this year. Wandrish between the circles now to Laster. Going deep into the chart right now. Laster from the foul line, well short.
They're in the
rebound tapped out. About a 12 second differential here between the game and the shot clock. To see Rob Poole out there, but they don't have it much deeper, so you're gonna have to have a starter out there. Although Crew's not in the game,
Steven
surprisingly.
Yeah. The forgotten man.
And inside the layup is up and in for Jared Jones. 80-57 Greyhounds, 24 seconds to go. Left it into the front court. We'll see if the Saints get off one final shot. Pass deflected to Hopper with 10 seconds to go. Marcus just kind of through a chest pass at the rim that fell about 4 feet shy of the rim. And that'll wrap it up. Another disappointing loss for Siena as the Greyhounds race past the Saints, the defending MAC champs, take it tonight by a final score of 80-57.